Hello, I'm Mrityunjay, 20 years old and a participant of DRDC 2021. I introduce you to Galaxys, a single stage rocket made on the Open Rocket software. So I would quickly first like to share all the constraints of my rocket according to the given lesson plan from SDNX. So the length is 47.4 centimeters with an apogee of 2012 meters, maximum velocity 301 meter per second, maximum acceleration 329 meter per second square with a stability of 2.09 calibers. Now, as per the lesson plan, it has a total impulse of 251 newton seconds and the propellant weight is 116 grams. Now, I would bifurcate each and every part of the rocket. I would first start with the nose cone. So the nose cone is 8.4 centimeters long, base diameter 3 centimeters, wall thickness of 0.2 centimeters. It is ogive shaped. I have chosen this shape because it has a smooth transition to the body tube and it produces a smooth aerodynamic wake. And that helps in the stability of the rocket. Also, it prevents any kind of interruption that comes from the wind due to a pointed tip. Coming to the shoulder, I have made it end capped so that it is intact with the secondary body tube. Coming to the next part, I have got two sets of body tubes. One is the primary body tube and the secondary body tube. So I would first like to describe the primary body tube. The primary body tube is 19 centimeters long, outer diameter 4 centimeters, and the other parameters as per the screen. Talking about the inner components of the body tube, the body tube consists of an engine block, inner tube, and three sets of freeform fins. The inner tube is 3.6 centimeters in outer diameter with a length of 7 centimeters. It is a single clustered inner tube that has a motor. Basically, the primary body tube has two motors. Then, coming to the freeform fin set, it has got three sets of freeform fin sets. I have designed these in such a way, first of all the three fin sets are airfoil shaped. We all know that airfoil shape is the best for any kind of propulsion, be it planes or rockets. I have made it in an airfoil shape so that aerodynamic stability is maintained in all the three fin sets. Also, I have given it an innovative touch. I made it in such a shape because it increased the stability of my rocket as well as the apogee and the maximum velocity. Then, coming to the transition, I have used two transitions in this rocket. The first transition that connects the primary and the secondary body tube, I have made this with the transition length of 3 centimeters. Why I have made this is so that it can keep the aerodynamic wake stabilized, and when the wind grazes on the surface of the transition, it can perfectly move on to the fins and then to the second transition to perfectly close the aerodynamic wake, and hence creating a better stability and less roll or pitch or unnecessary yaw in the movement of the rocket. And in turn, it would give a better reach to the apogee, and after that, a better recovery in turn. Coming to the second transition, the second transition is here so that the aerodynamic wake can perfectly be closed after the end of the rocket. The third fin set also contributes to the same. I have made this fin set in such a way so that the aerodynamic wake is perfectly closed after the rocket ends. Now, coming to the most important part of the rocket, the power source, that are the motors. So I have used two motors, one in the primary body tube and one inside the inner tube, that is the cluster. So the one that I've used in the body tube is the G138T with a thrust, a total impulse of 167 newton seconds. I chose this motor because it has a continuously increasing thrust curve that gives me a stability until the rocket reaches the apogee. And it gives me a good thrust starting somewhere between 100 and 125 and reaching up to somewhere near 200. So that ensures that till the rocket reaches the apogee, it will provide constant thrust and the curve will increase up to a particular point. Now coming to the second motor, that is G101T5. I chose this because first of all, it completes the requirement as given in the constraint. And the most important thing is the thrust curve again. So as we can see that it is a stabilized thrust curve throughout, and the primary motor that I described before will ensure that once the propellant fuel in this motor starts running out, it will recover for that. And it has with a very less mass, this motor provides a good thrust. That is why I use this, and it can boost up the performance of the primary motor that I introduced you before this. Now, that was all about the rocket. Also, I have given it an innovative touch. Also, it is very feasible. No part in this rocket is such that would not be feasible. I have given it my own graphics, and I have designed these fin sets in an innovative way, in such a way that it provides greater stability. We have seen in the past how rocket launches have failed due to unnecessary roll or pitch that was not required during the spaceflight test. Also, this finset has given me a good apogee as well as the maximum velocity. Now, quickly coming on to the flight simulations. I did the flight simulations of the same, and I got an apogee of 2012 meters as per the rocket, the original one, and a grounded velocity of 2.65 meter per second only. That means that once the rocket lands, it would be perfectly stabilized and it would go through a safe landing. Now coming to the last part, that is the secondary body tube. The secondary body tube is 16 centimeters long and it consists of the parachute. The parachute is made up of ripstin nylon, 150 centimeters in diameter. I have chosen this material because it is a strong material, a light material, and would provide all the necessary drag that would be required for the rocket while it comes down in the recovery stage. Second comes the shroud lines. I have used 6 shroud lines in elastic cord, because if any mishappening occurs with the rocket, if it goes to any unnecessary position, the elastic cord would be, through its elasticity, would help the rocket reach back into its original position. Now, coming on to the flight simulations and plots. I created a time to stability plot, and this is the plot that I have got. This shows that the stability is almost is same throughout the reaching of the apogee. Also, I have created this design because it can be used, it can be scaled up and can be used for deployment of satellites, GPS satellites. Now, these days, as we move on to the next higher generations, we see the use of transport is changing. And I plan to use this as a transport detection facility. It can carry a satellite to the orbit of the Earth that can be used to map transport all over the globe, and transportation, the transportation vehicles can be driverless and autonomous. And this rocket can be used to deliver the rocket up there. That would use the GPS technology and in turn help transport facility. All the people would be able to access the data from the satellite, and the transportation would be autonomously operative. So thank you so much. That was all from my rocket, and I named the rocket Galaxis. This is the design of my rocket. I will also attach an image, the simulation graphs and the PDF that I generated from this rocket on the drive link. Thank you so much.